Their aquarium might be closed for a little while, but curiosity is never canceled. Join us as we dive in and explore mystery surrounding some of your favorite animals, like fish. Do fish remember? Can a fish tell time? Who is sneakier, a fish or a kid? Let's find out.
First things first, what do you call more than one fish? Fish or fishes? If you thought fish, you're right. And if you thought fishes, well, you're also right. When more than one fish ends up on your dinner plate, we say fish. When there are two or more of the same kind of fish in your home aquarium, we say fish. But when scientists talk about living fish of different species in our homes, public aquariums, or out in the wild, they say fishes. For example, one clownfish plus another clownfish together equals fish. But a clownfish plus a blue regal tang equals fishes. At first thought, a fish might seem pretty simple. But the world of fishes is a world of amazing diversity. Consider just a few of the incredible abilities fishes possess. They're nimble schoolers, cautious parents, long-distance travelers, fantastic predators, slow, graceful swimmers, cautious burrowers, sharpshooters, skillful builders, and cooperative partners. Pay close attention as we explore the world of fishes, how they remember, solve complicated problems, tell time, and outsmart other animals. You might find there are ways a fish is sneakier than you are. When you live underwater, avoiding becoming another animal's dinner is one of your highest priorities. Fish can use many strategies to avoid predators. How many can you think of? Some fish are too big, too fast, or even too toxic for other animals to eat. But what's a smaller, slower, non-toxic fish to do? It gets sneaky. Wait, fish can be sneaky?
Sometimes a fish has to use sneaky strategies to outsmart animals that might want to eat it. Let's take a look at these two fish. One of them is poisonous. One of them is a copycat. The mimic filefish wears the same patterns as poisonous saddle pufferfish. Same yellow tail, same dots over its body, and dark bars lining its back. Can you spot any differences? In a grouping of 100 saddle pufferfish, scientists estimate 5 of them are mimic filefish, hiding in plain sight. If you were a predator, would you want to get close enough to find out for sure? Let's look at another. One of these fish is a venomous coral catfish. The other is a young engineer goby. Both have long bodies, dark coloring with white stripes. Can you tell the difference? Young engineer gobies look so much like these coral catfish, they go out and collect food unbothered by predators. Sometimes the fish is the predator outsmarting its prey. Can you find a fish among these corals and sponges? What about here? Or how about here? Wait a moment and see if one moves. A frogfish's lumpy, squat body blends in easily among corals and sponges. Once it chooses a place, it can slowly change colors to match its home. But the sneakiness of the frogfish doesn't stop there. While in disguise, a frogfish goes fishing. It carries its own fishing pole and its own bait. From its forehead, a spine sticks out. What does the tip look like to you? A worm? A shrimp? Sometimes the frogfish waves the bait around. When prey goes in for a nibble, the frogfish swallows it whole. A bigger fish might be fooled into thinking it's safe from the frogfish's jaws, but a frogfish can swallow prey pretty close to its own size.
Imagine swallowing a snap the same size you are. So who is sneakier, a fish or a kid? Fish trick other animals to survive, but a kid plays tricks for fun. So who do you think is sneakier here, a fish or a kid?
Fill in the blank. Fish have a good or bad memory? Some fish remember ways to outsmart other animals to survive, but how much can a fish remember? Unlike what you may have heard, that fish can only remember for just a few seconds, most fish can actually remember quite a lot.
Archerfish hunt by spitting streams of water at bugs on overhanging tree branches and knocking them into the water. Archerfish have great memories, and they solve complicated problems as they hunt for food. Because of this, we've been able to train archerfish at shed to spit water at almost anything they think could be food. We start with food on sticks. The archerfish spit at the food, and it falls in the water where they eat it. After a while, we show the archerfish just a stick with no food on it. If they spit at it, we drop the food in the water to let them know that was the behavior we are looking for. The next step was to show them different things to spit at. The archerfish don't always come near new objects right away. It takes the fish a little time to get used to new things. Once they remember the objects, they come swimming over as soon as they see them.
Do you think you could spit as well as an archerfish? An archerfish can hit a bug on a branch up to 6 feet away. And keep in mind, most archerfish are about 7 inches long. How's your math? To knock a bug down, an archerfish has to calculate how high and how hard the difference in angles are underwater. That's at least high school level math. Earlier, we talked about how fish remember. Now, let's talk about the importance of time. Time is important in the life of a fish. Why do you think that is? Certain fish are active at different times, day and night. And some fish are most active around specifically sunrise and sunset. What time are you most active? Seasons also play an important role in the life of a fish. Can you think of any reasons why?
Spring marks mating season for many fishes, especially those living in and around the Great Lakes. For a Great Lakes species called suckers, spring kickstarts their yearly migration. This means they swim in a big group out of the lakes to streams, rivers, and creeks where the fish release their eggs and start to reproduce. But without a calendar, how do suckers know spring has arrived? Can fish tell time? That's the mystery we're trying to solve here at Shed Aquarium. We know suckers use clues in their environment, like water temperature and speed of the water flowing out of rivers and creeks, to signal their migration. But we don't know what combination of signals they use. How do we find out? We investigate. Let's think about what we need to know to figure this out. When do the suckers start swimming towards creeks and rivers? Is the water a certain temperature when they start? When and where do we find the largest groups of suckers? When do they stop? What other signals could be present in the water along the way? To find out, we need a few tools. We place electronic devices called data loggers in the water. It records water temperature and water flow every 15 minutes. We place tracking devices inside some of the suckers, like the microchips some people place inside a pet dog or cat in case they get lost. This way, we can track how many suckers return to the same waters. Solving this mystery will take some time. We have to track the suckers from multiple spring migrations. Studying the history of their migrations will help us find patterns in the suckers' movements. The exciting thing about science is we don't know everything. There's still a lot left to learn.
Everything we know about the animal world, we know because someone asked a question. Continue investigating animal mysteries on your own. Find your own questions about the animal world and try to figure out your own answers. Curiosity never has to end, even if this video does.
Today we solve the mysteries of, do fish remember? Can fish tell time? And who is sneakier, a fish or a kid? Which answer surprised you the most? Let us know. Thank you for joining us, and thank you for staying home with Shed Aquarium. To continue exploring fish mysteries, visit us online.